Hello guys, welcome to the dojo. Most players still don't know what to do when Orisa is around. We are going to give you the full picture about her, so you can understand how to play with Orisa, as Orisa, or against the team where she is present. When a new character comes out, the community usually has trouble figuring it out. Look at Sombra for example. Even pro gamers had very different opinions of her for a long time. She can be used very effectively in the right hands, but mostly avoided due to the lack of experience. This effect applies to solo queue too, where players tend to heavily disagree with picks not following the meta. Orisa is still a puzzle for most players. She is supposed to be a tank, but goes down very quickly to direct damage. She can do a lot of damage herself, but is very slow moving while firing her gun, so what's the deal with her? Let's start with the very basics. We need to understand her character, abilities and role in the game, then we can share more in-depth knowledge building on these foundations. We are interested what you think about Orisa right now, share it in a comment below. First, let's cover her basics. Note that these values are suspect to change in any patch, the numbers we use here are her current stats. She has 200 health and 200 armor. Having half of her HP and armor is important because it is a great advantage against enemies firing a lot of small bullets like Tracer and Soldier. Armor mitigates a lot of that. Fortify is also most effective when you still have armor on. Her primary fire is a fast projectile weapon with 150 MO. She can do a whopping 1800 damage with a full clip, and the projectiles does not have falloff. One important thing is that she gets slower when firing her weapon, just like D.Va. An important concept is leading the targets when firing, predicting their movements, and pre-firing. Her first ability is Halt. This is a small graviton charge that travels at slow speed until it collides with something. Orisa can reactivate the ability to pull enemies together. We are going to discuss this ability more in depth soon, as it has a lot of really great uses. The next ability is Protective Barrier. She can fire it in an arch to really long distances to deploy a 900 HP shield. This shield is the most important part of her kit. A good Orisa can use it very effectively to cover her team and make strong pushes. It has a relatively low cooldown, so you can use it a lot to gain more effective HP. More about it later. She doesn't have any real escape ability, but her Fortify makes Orisa really tanky for a short while. She also becomes immune to any crowd control effects. The ability has a low cooldown, so it can be and should be used frequently to mitigate damage and body block the enemy line of sight. It is important to notice that Orisa will go down very quickly if she is without a shield when the Fortify ends, so keep this in mind. Her ultimate ability is Supercharger. She places a deployable with 200 health that gives every teammate plus 50% damage increase in a 25 meter radius for 15 seconds. This radius is really long, so you can hide it behind walls and attack or defend with a plus 50% damage. If handled well, this ability can win fights for your team in itself. So these are the basics. Now we are going to see them more in depth. There is a drill video about learning how to aim with Orisa, check it out if you are interested in that topic, we are not going to cover it here. Notice that the cooldowns are relatively low, so you want to actively use them for the best results. Don't forget this when you are in the heat of battle. The first thing you need to know about Orisa is how to use her primary fire. A very important part of her kit, she can do monstrous amounts of damage up close if handled correctly. The bullets do 12 damage and are fast moving projectiles with no damage falloff. The weapon has 150 MO, meaning you can pump out 1800 damage per clip at a rate of 12 shots per second for 144 DPS. And of course it can headshot enemies, potentially doubling the damage. Having no damage falloff, Orisa's basic attack is a really good tool for harassing enemies at range. It is not ideal for long range sniping as the projectiles have some travel time and are easily avoidable. Orisa is really strong on mid to close range, and she can dance around the shield, more about it later, while continuously firing. A 200 HP hero can go down in 1.5 seconds, or 0.8 if all shots land to the head. That's pretty good for a tank. It is important to learn how much you need to lead your target in order to hit them at different ranges. The farther they are from you, the more you need to be able to predict their movement. Use a crosshair that is not covering a lot from your screen, and useful for precise shots like short crosshairs. Enabling bloom is a personal preference, we like it on, but the spread is random so you cannot control it like soldiers. A really important part of Orisa's basic attack is reloading. It takes 2.5 seconds to reload her gun, that's a lot. A good flanker can make short work of you in that time. So, make sure that you only start reloading when it is necessary and you have cover where you can back off during the animation. If you still have some bullets in the clip and want to get back into the fight immediately, you can cancel the reload with a melee attack and start firing again. Alright, let's continue with the Halt ability. It's a mini graviton with 8 seconds cooldown. This ability has a lot of uses that you need to know about to be really effective with Orisa. We would suggest you go to the practice range and experience the speed and the length of the grav effect of this ability. The power of the halt ability is not only powerful because it pulls enemies to a place. It must be used as a zoning tool, as the enemies will try to keep away from it as much as possible, knowing that it can disrupt their movements and position greatly. As a bonus, you can use it to scout around the choke and see how many enemies there by watching the beams connecting to them. The following are some example uses for the halt ability so you don't just spam it randomly but understand and utilize it in a way that creates opportunities for your team. A good thing to do is to use it vertically, pulling enemies upward. They are predictable when falling down and will not be able to escape for one more second, that is sometimes enough to finish them off. The first common usage is to pull enemies from high ground. This ability is really valuable in creating equal fights for your team. If you are approaching an enemy position and they have the advantage of the high ground, you can fire your halt ability, pull them down and let your team do their worst. This can throw them off if their strategy revolves around fighting from top down. Make sure that you practice the timing for this move. The next usage is when you want to attack a choke point, but the enemy is behind a shield you have hard time breaking. The ability pulls targets out from behind shield, so you can use it to target a secondary tank or a hero playing close to the front line and help your team get a pick. Make sure that you call this so a Roadhog will be able to hook a target, for example. It can also be used to pull targets upward from behind a shield. This makes them reachable by some characters, and falling down also makes them predictable. The halt ability displaces enemies, so it can open up ways for your allies to use their ultimate. Pulling defenders away or upwards is a really great way to do unexpected things. You can pull a Reinhardt up and allow your own Rein buddy to use the Earth Shatter when the shield is not blocking. You can pull a Reinhardt sideways, opening up a view for a McCree ultimate. There is a big list of combos there, make sure that you think them through and use them in your next Orisa game. This gives a good idea who to combo with. The next one is chasing. Catching fleeing enemies have never been so easy. Fire the orb when you suspect that they are going to flee, pull them upwards and back to you to finish them off. Low health enemies are a good indication, but Genji players will usually flee after using the reflect, Tracer after recall, Zarya after their shield was used and depleted. You get the idea, predict them and punish them. The next usage is protecting allies. Halt is a really good ability for protecting your buddies. You can pull away flankers easily, making way for your support and allowing damage dealers to do their work on them. The halt ability is really good to pull an ulting Genji away from your team, as he is really slow without a dash. You can deny the whole ultimate with a good halt. The same applies to a lot of boosted targets. You can pull a Pharah behind the wall to deny her ultimate too. Think of creative ways. The last usage is securing fallbacks. You can fire the ability when you are fleeing to stagger the enemy, allowing your team to backpedal to safety. As you can see, halt is really about positional plays and disrupting enemy movements in order to gain some kind of advantage. Alright, let's talk about Fortify. Fortify mitigates 50% of all damage for 4 seconds with a 10 seconds cooldown. It also makes you immune to all crowd control effects, but doesn't protect your allies from it. If you want to learn how and when to use Fortify, you need to use it when you are still healthy, whenever you started to receive damage. This is much like Zarya's shield in its usage. Never use it preemptively. Wait until the enemy really wants to focus you and use it then. It is important to know that it is much more effective at mitigating damage when you still have armor up, so try to engage with it like so. Fortify is not for withstanding a lot of punishment, but to negate some when you are getting focused. Using this ability well will help you win every 1v1 situation in the game. Combine it with your barrier for maximum effect. More about it soon. The first concept we are talking about is body blocking. An important thing to do is to use your huge body to block vision and abilities that would target your most important allies. By standing between an enemy soldier and your Mercy, you can save her just long enough to be able to use her ultimate. Body blocking is an important concept to learn and use with any tank or off tank. Try to use Fortify when you are eating an enemy ability or damage, making sure that you don't sacrifice yourself only if really needed. Fortify is also really useful to deny a Roadhog hook or a Reinhardt charge. Time it when you suspect he is going to use it and block their abilities. It can get you out of a May freeze as well. This is what makes it really hard to win a 1v1 against the good Orisa. If the situation calls for a fallback, Fortify can be used to make sure that you can flee. Use it to deny enemy abilities that would slow you down and reduce the damage of course. In this situation, when you flee, you should never shoot as it slows you down. Okay, now we get to the protective barrier ability that is something that should be used all the time with Orisa. It's a shield that has 900 health, 20 seconds duration and a 12 seconds cooldown. It can be fired in an arch to quite long distances. As Reinhardt is known for the shield, this remote barrier is the trademark of Orisa. Don't forget that the cooldown starts as soon as you use the ability, so the shield can usually be kept up all the time. Let's talk about the basics of shield usage. The main purpose of shields in this game is not to soak damage. They should always be used to defend your team when something is actively happening, making sure that they are protected. A Reinhardt who holds up the shield but not protecting anybody is not a good Reinhardt. The same applies to Orisa's shield, but it is more like Winston's. You don't use it to protect against damage head-on, but to create opportunities for pushes or to separate enemies with it. It's basically a 900 HP pack that you can use regularly. The first concept we need to learn about is barrier dancing. Barrier dancing or shield dancing is a move that you need to master. It is used to help the shield stay alive longer, allowing your team to have larger room to do their jobs. The idea is to put a shield down and move around it, blocking the line of sight of the enemy. If you body block the shield, it will stay up longer. If you use the shield for protecting, you can mitigate some damage. Do this to ensure that you can push in with your team, falling behind it to receive heals when you need it, or to win 1v1 situations by moving around the shield in a way that doesn't allow your enemy to hit you. Okay, how to push with a shield? Use your shield to gain ground for the team. When you are pushing into the enemy team, it is important that you use the 900 effective HP as good as you can. Start going towards the enemy, then use Fortify and shoot your shield right away in front of them. The shield should land before your damage reduction ends. It is advisable not to shoot when you are charging in, as you are going to be too slow to reach them. Pull them apart with help and let your team work on them when you reach the enemy positions. Okay, how to defend with the shield? When you are defending a point or a choke, placing the shield right in front of the enemy team is a bad decision. They will melt it in 3 seconds. It's better to use the shield wisely and protect your damage dealers, enabling them to have an extended cover that they can use to do damage. If there is a soldier on the high ground needing a little bit more protection, give the shield to him. Another important time frame is when the enemy decides to engage. Cut them half with the shield so the backline cannot support the frontline effectively. A well-coordinated counteroffense will catch the enemies by surprise. Okay, so let's talk a bit more about separating enemies. There are some combos that depend heavily on line of sight. The Zarya Tracer Wombo combo is such one, but the Nanoblade Genji goes down quickly too without healing. Thus, creating a distraction with a shield and denying certain abilities to pass for a few seconds can go a long way. Use it to your own advantage. Okay, let's talk about shooting the shield straight up. This is a technique that can be used when defending stationary positions. Shoot your shield straight up when the one placed is about to go down but still has some juice in it. The cooldown instantly starts, but a new shield will only get deployed when it lands. Time it well and you will have a shield deployed and the next coming up in a few seconds. It's really great against strong pushes. Okay, now we get to the ultimate. Let's talk about Supercharger. Supercharger gives plus 50% damage boost to every ally in a 25 meter radius for 15 seconds. It is a deployable with 200 health, so it needs to be protected in order to gain the maximum value from it. You want to make sure that you protect it as long as possible, so deploy a shield first and put the deployable behind it. Let's talk about Supercharger in defense. It is easier to deploy it in defensive scenarios, as you can use the terrain to protect it from harm. Because of the stationary position of the defenders, however, enemy characters will have an easier time to figure out where it is. It can be surprisingly strong in the defense if the team sticks in the radius of the ultimate. Don't use it preemptively, only when the enemy decides to commit to the attack. If they trick you into using it and they retreat, you wasted a really strong ultimate. Try to wait until they are bringing the fight close to you. When you are attacking, it is not that easy to decide when and where to place it. You want to make sure that it stays up as long as possible. Put down a shield, place a supercharger behind it and use the presence of your frontline to further protect it from harm. If you can get one or two picks before it goes down, it was worth it. You can also use it to create a diversion as a secondary effect. The defenders will want to eliminate it as quickly as possible, and you can use this to your advantage. Focus the ones going for it, you can kill them quickly if they tunnel vision to the deployable, making them predictable. Farm your ult as quickly as possible. This is a cheesy tactic that works well in primate teams. You need someone to play Ana for you and charge the Ana boost quickly by soaking damage, shield dancing without fortify. Then Ana hoots you and you do enough damage to be able to place your supercharger. Plus 50% damage for the whole team very quickly if done right. In the next one, we are going to cover stuff you need to know about when playing Orisa in a team. Hey there Orisa, nice to meet you here in the dojo. Please introduce yourself quickly.
I'm still new at this.
Okay, that was really quick. We want to help players understand how you work in every level. What is your number one tip to give to them?
You are advised to move behind my barrier.
Alright, that should be easy. We are going to see what to do and what not to do when you're around. Do you have any message to people who call for a swap when they see you in the game?
Cease your resistance.
That should teach them. Thank you for answering our questions. You can go now.
I'm not moving.
Do you have something else to say?
Your safety is my primary concern.
Oh, so nice of you. See you around. If you like what we are doing, please subscribe, give us a thumbs up and share this video. See you guys next time. This time we'll have to join forces.